Please start.
First of all, I would like to congratulate Dr. Upreti sir, Dr. Natasha ma'am. This is LIRADS. It is Liver Imaging Reporting and Data System. Why this came into picture? It was just to standardize the terminology, the interpretation and reporting of liver nodules, and to improve the communication between the clinicians, radiologists, and also the researchers. So if you see the manual of the LIRADS, it is around an 850-page document. So only the relevant sections will be highlighted today. So LIRADS algorithms, basically it deals into surveillance of HCC, the diagnosis portion of the HCC, and also the treatment portion of the HCC. So today's lecture, I will be highlighting only the diagnosis portion of the HCC through CT and MRI, which is important for day-to-day practice. So if you see this version 2018, these are the various categories which you should know. This is the LIRADS NC, that is the not categorizable lesion. Then you have the 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, depending upon the benign nature or the definitely HCC. The 5 version is, LR5 is the definite HCC, 1 is the definitely benign, and LRM is a malignant lesion, but it is not necessarily an HCC. LRTIV, it is LR tumor in vein. We will see each categories in detail. So how to use LIRADS? We have to follow these steps. First, you should identify the population, then look for the observation, then follow the algorithm. So we will see one by one. First, we see the population. So which population you apply the LIRADS? This is very important. Apply LIRADS only in cirrhotic patients or chronic hepatitis B viral infection patients or patients having current or prior HCC. Do not apply LIRADS in patients which are less than 18 years of age without the above risk factors, with cirrhosis due to congenital hepatic fibrosis or cirrhosis due to vascular disorders. And you should apply LIRADS only in multiphasic exams which are performed with CT or MRI with extracellular contrast agents or patobiliary contrast agents. Most important is, do not assign LIRADS to path proven malignancies, that is pathologically proven malignancies or pathologically proven benign entities. Do not provide LIRADS categories in these lesions. So this is also important. You should have a dedicated imaging before you apply LIRADS. Should have a triphasic CT or MR abdomen with arterial phase, portal venous phase and the delayed phase. And if you are doing an MR, you should also have a hepatobiliary phase. So we have seen the population where we apply. Now, you should have an observation to apply LIRADS. So what is an observation? It is a distinct area in the liver parenchyma, which is different from the normal liver or the background liver. So in this case, if you see, this is an observation. So once your patient has passed the population in which you apply the LIRADS, you should have an observation where you want to apply the LIRADS. So after you have an observation, you follow an algorithm. And that algorithm is in the manual. So this algorithm looks very dangerous, but I will try to make it simple for you all. So this algorithm, I will divide into two parts. First part, I will just highlight this portion of the algorithm, which is these five entities, which is the LIRADS non-categorizable lesion, tumor in vein, LR1, LR2 and the LRM. So if you are able to categorize an observation into these categories, you do not need to go into the second part of the algorithm. So best is you try to see if your observation falls into these categories. Like what is LRNC? If you see this five images, same patient, different phases. So arterial phase, you can see some artifact. Portal venous phase, again an artifact. But the diffusion-weighted images and the hepatobiliary phase, they are acquired in a good way. So in these cases, you have to label these lesions as LRNC because the images are either not acquired properly or they have been omitted. So in these cases, best is, how are you going to report it? That there is a lesion of this many size, not definitely able to characterize, but it shows some diffusion restriction and a defect in the hepatobiliary phase. So this may suggest an HCC which requires further imaging. So you can put this as a LRNC, that is not categorizable lesion. Then if you have an LRTIV, that is a tumor invade, a lesion which shows thrombus or a tumoral thrombus. Any lesion which having a tumoral thrombus is a LRTIV. It is important to identify these lesions because these patients are not going to undergo for transplant. Now LR1 and LR2 are simple lesions. They are benign lesions which include cyst, hemangioma, perfusion alterations, hepatic fat deposition or sparing, pseudomasses or confluent scars. So if you see the examples of LR1 and LR2 lesions, these are all patients with cirrhotic liver or chronic hepatitis B infections. So if you see, this is a simple cyst, T2 hyperintense, no enhancement. This is a hemangioma, which is bright on T2, which shows some peripheral nodular enhancement and gradual thinning. And this is a perfusion alteration, which you can see a wedge-shaped area of focal hyperenhancement with undistorted vessels. The vessels are not distorted. So this is a perfusion alteration. But this type of lesion is only going to be identified when you gain some expertise. So these are benign lesions which have to be categorized either as LR1 or LR2. Now coming to this type of category of lesion, that is LRM. This is a slightly different lesion, which is a malignant lesion, but not typical for HCC. Like for example, it could be an intrahepatic cholangio, combined HCC hepatocholangio, or a non-HCC malignancy like a metastasis. Could be atypical HCCs also, like serous HCC, steatohepatitic HCC, or some poorly differentiated HCC. So how are you going to identify these LRM lesions? LRM lesions are basically lesions which show rim type of arterial enhancement and peripheral washout, or some targetoid type of pattern of diffusion restriction. We will see the example. So if you see this example, if you see carefully, see there is a rim arterial enhancement with peripheral washout and delayed central filling. So this is not a typical behavior of an HCC. So this is a LRM lesion. So if I go back to this slide, so this is any lesion which shows rim arterial enhancement, peripheral washout, delayed central enhancement, targetoid type of restriction or hepatobiliary phase enhancement, then you should categorize these lesions as LRM, because again, these patients are not going to go for transplant. So coming back to the algorithm, I have finished the first part. So if you are able to characterize these lesions into five of the any one, then your LIRADS reporting is finished. You do not need to go to the second part. But if your lesion does not fit into these five categories, you go into the second part of the algorithm, which is looks like this. So in this algorithm, if you see carefully, there are only three types of LIRADS categories, that either 3, 4, or 5. And this type of table, if you see, there are some terms like arterial phase hyperenhancement, no FA. They say this as FA, arterial phase hyperenhancement, non-rim FA, some size of the lesions, and some major features. Major features could be none of them, could be one, or could be more than two. Major features are enhancing capsule, non-peripheral washout, and threshold growth. So we will look these entities one by one, what exactly these means. So arterial phase hyperenhancement, there are three examples. If you see carefully, these all are arterial phase, no FA, that is no arterial phase hyperenhancement. So this is not going to be an LR5 lesion. This is a non-rim FA, that is, this type of lesions are most likely to become are most likely to be HCC. That is, they are showing full arterial enhancement. And this is a rim arterial phase enhancement, which I already told, this falls into an LRM category. So sometimes what happens is you are not sure whether there is some arterial phase enhancement or not. So what LIRADS says, if you are unsure, then say there is no arterial phase hyperenhancement. Similarly, if you are not sure whether there is rim arterial phase enhancement or non-rim, then categorize this as rim arterial phase hyperenhancement. And these patients may need to undergo biopsy to be proved whether these are atypical HCCs or some other malignancies, Because if it is a different malignancy, patients is out from the transplant list. Coming to washout, what does washout mean? If you see these examples, in this example, arterial phase, hyper enhancement, peripheral. And again, if you see, there is a peripheral washout. The full lesion is not showing washout and not full lesion is showing arterial enhancement. In this case, if you see, there is an arterial phase hyper enhancement, almost the entire lesion shows enhancement, and there is a non-peripheral washout, that is the entire lesion is showing washout. So sometimes what happens is, arterial phase hyper enhancement is there, but you are not sure whether there is washout or not. The lesion becomes iso-intense. So in these type of cases, do not use the word washout. Instead, use fade. Because if you use a washout term, it is one of the major criteria for diagnosing HCC. For in these cases, you have to use the word fade. Again, sometimes there will be two lesions. One lesion might show washout. Another lesion may become iso-intense, which shows fade, fading. It is not washout. So again, if you are not sure about washout versus no washout, do not characterize this as washout. And if you are not sure about peripheral or non-peripheral washout, characterize better to characterize as peripheral washout and undergo for biopsy in these cases. Now size, how do you measure size in cases of hepatic nodules? You have to measure from outer edge to outer edge, from inner capsule, you have to include the capsule, you have to include the longest axis, take an entire observation, also include the outer nodule, do not include the perfusion alteration of the liver parenchyma. And mostly do not try to measure the liver's lesion size in the arterial phase. Now, how do you define threshold growth? Threshold growth is more than 50% increase in size of the mass or the nodule in less than 6 months. We will see this with an example. This is a lesion of 12 mm size. In around 4 month follow up, this has increased to about 20 mm. So in less than 6 months, the size has increased to about 67%. So increase in more than 50% in less than 6 months, that means there is a threshold growth. Now enhancing capsule. Capsule is how the Lyrad's document defined capsule, as a smooth, uniform, sharp border around most or all of an observation, unequivocally thicker or more conspicuous than fibrotic tissue. This we will see with an example. Here again you see, this is a non-rim arterial phase hyper-enhancing lesion with non-peripheral washout, and if you see carefully, there is an enhancing capsule. Similarly, in this lesion, there is an enhancing capsule. But look at this lesion. You are not sure whether there is a capsule or no capsule. What the definition says, the capsule should be thicker than the fibrotic tissue. So if you see carefully, this capsule is not thicker than the fibrotic rim. So it is difficult to label this as a capsule. And sometimes what happens is, you can see corona and the capsule together in a single lesion. What is corona? Corona is the spread of the tumor in the peripheral sinusoids, usually seen in the late arterial phase. If you see carefully, there is some enhancement of this hepatic parenchyma outside the capsule. So this is corona and this is the rim, is the capsule. So whenever you find an individual observation, what findings you have to report? You have to look at the size. You have to see which segment is this lesion. Better to define the series and the image number. See if there are major features, ancillary features, and apply the Lyrad's category. So up to 5 of the highest category observations should be reported individually. Like at least 5 lesions has to be reported, like LR4, 5, TR and the LRM categories has to be reported. And additional observations may be reported in aggregate. So this is an example of a Lyrad's reporting template. It could be either in this format or in this format. So what we are going to report is the size, which segment, which series or image number, whether there is arterial phase hyper enhancement or no, washout yes or no, capsule yes or no, and if there are any ancillary features, and then you finally apply the Lyrad's category. So now we will see some cases to clarify more. So if you see carefully, this is the arterial phase and this is the portal venous phase and the hepatic venous phase. So this is a lesion which is around 9 mm in size. So if you see, this is the table. So this lesion is showing almost complete arterial enhancement. So this is a north rim type of arterial phase hyper enhancement. Lesion size is 9 mm. So this will fall into this cell. And it does not show any washout or a capsule. That means additional major features are none. So most likely it is going to fall into Lyrax 3 category. Another case, if you see carefully, these are the different phases. This is a 22 mm size observation in the liver parenchyma, showing a non-rim arterial phase hyper-enhancement. Size is more than 22 mm, that means it is going to fall in this cell. And it shows washout and a capsule. That is the major feature. There are at least two major features. So it will fall into Lyrax 5 category. Another example, lesion which is almost more than 2 centimeters in size, non-rim type of arterial phase hyper-enhancement with a capsule and washout. So again, this is going to fall into Lyrax 5 categories. Now, one tricky example I would like to show. This is a lesion measuring around 10 to 19 mm in size, showing some arterial phase hyper-enhancement and washout. So, if you see non-rim effect, that this lesion is showing a non-rim type of arterial phase hyper-enhancement and a washout, but no capsule. So, if you see, there is only one major feature and this lesion falls into this diagonal cell. So, once your lesion falls into this diagonal cell, how you apply Lyrax? So, just see. So, what the Lyrax document says is, once the lesion falls into this diagonal cell, you have to look for the major feature. So if there is a non-peripheral washout and a threshold growth, either of this, either non-peripheral washout or threshold growth, apply Lyrax 5. And if you are seeing only enhancing capsule, then it is a Lyrax 4 lesion. So in our case, there is a washout. That means it is a Lyrax 5 lesion. So in this cell, if it is a washout or a threshold growth, LR5, only capsule, then LR4. So this is a Lyrax 5 lesion. Now we have finished the algorithm. Now we will look at the ancillary features. So ancillary features are optional. It depends upon the confidence of the radiologist, whether you would like to apply or not. So what happens is, there are some features, ancillary features which are described in the document, which favors benignity of the lesions, like size stable for more than 2 years, reduction in the size, if the lesion parallels the blood pool, like hemangiomas, if they are undistorted vessels, like perfusion anomalies, if the iron in mass, which is more than the liver, marked T2 hyperintensity and the hepatobiliary phase isointensity. And some favor HCC. These are the ancillary features which favor HCC, like if there is a non-enhancing capsule, nodule in nodule, mosaic architecture, blood products, or some fat in the mass. So what the Lyrax document says, if there are features of benignity, then you can downgrade by one category. So like suppose there is one ancillary feature which favors benign nature of that observation, then you can downgrade from LR4 to LR3. Similarly, you can upgrade when there are ancillary features of malignancy, but you cannot upgrade from LR4 to LR5. Last portion, the tie-breaking rules. Again, it depends on the confidence of the radiologist. So what is tie-breaking rule? Suppose if you are not sure whether there is a tumor in vein, yes or no, then better to characterize as no tumor in vein. And if you are unsure between two categories, choose the one reflecting the lower certainty. Like if you are not sure about LR5 versus LR4, better to downgrade the lesion for benignity. And if you are not sure whether it is LR1, LR2, then better to characterize as LR2, higher the upgradation for the benignity. And last step is the final check. Once assigned Lyrax category to an observation, do final check whether we have applied Lyrax in a proper way or not. So take home message is, it is a dynamic document. It keeps on changing every 3 to 4 years. It, of course, it improves the communication among the clinicians, radiologists and researchers. Report up to 5 of the highest categorized observations, especially the LR4. one can always have a free access to this document. So with this, I would like to conclude my lecture.